Welcome everyone.
Sapevo che deve...
Can you put down the light, please?
That's not possible.
Not possible? Okay, thank you. So, welcome everyone. For all of you that are in the room and the people that are joining us online.
Sorry.
It's a pleasure to me to see you finally each other again in person, and I'm very proud to welcome you here in Florence. I'm Luca De Lucchi, and I'm one of the attendees of Phosphor G 2022. But I'm also one of the volunteers of Phosphor G 2022. And finally, I'm the chair of Phosphor G 2022. I'm probably not the most appropriate person to do this opening. After all, I'm shy and my English is not the best. But since I'm the chair, that's it, it is what you'll get. So bear with me. Most of you don't know that the mother of Phosphor G was held the first time in Italy, in Trento, in 2002. I was not present, but from the face, it seemed there was the same spirit that is still present at the Phosphor G. And who do you believe that some of them are still part of our big family? After 20 years, the International Free Geographic Software Community is back in Italy, and we are really excited about it. I already talked too much, so now I'd like to give you an overview of what we achieved together. For 100 talks for the general session, 100 for the academic, and 100 for the workshop were submitted. Sorry. We are sorry, we could not accept all them, as they were many very interesting contributions, but we had a limited number of spaces. Never before had the academic and the workshop reached such a high number, and we are extremely proud of this. Today, we start our very own conference, but for the whole last week, there have been events in Florence related to our work. We started with the QGIS meeting and the State of the Map 2022, and moved with events organized by OTT and UMapper. I would like to thank these two initiatives that together with the conference travel grant made it possible to bring many people from more disadvantaged countries who otherwise would not have been able to attend. For the travel grant, it's still possible to donate. For more information, I suggest you look at the conference website. Finally, yesterday there was the event co-organized by Geo Chicas and Women Plus in Geospatial and the business-to-business event. I can say that all the events just mentioned were a huge success. And I hope in the future this formula can be used again, because I believe that bringing these events together allow more participants to be present while reducing cost for the participant, for example, transport, and can also lower the environment impact. And now, let's begin with our acknowledgement. Come sono andato, Andre? First of all, to our partner, the European Commission and the ESA, for the contributing to very interesting session that will be held in this room, for giving promise of the conference, the University of Florence, for providing space for worship and many side events, and finally Wikimedia Italia, with whom the GFOS Association, the OSGO local Italian local chapter, has been collaborating for years. Our sponsor. I won't mention a single one, as not make a distinction, and because there are so many of them. I never thought we could get so many sponsorship in terms of number and money. Thanks a lot, if it's possible to make this conference a little bit cheaper than before. It is also thanks to you. So now I leave the floor to my co-chair Bianca, who will introduce a few people who would like to say a few things. Thanks.
Okay. Good morning, everybody. It's an honor for me to participate with Luca in this opening session of the Phosphor G conference. And I would like to thank Luca for involving me as co-chair of the conference. Thank you, Luca. And thank you to all the volunteers and all the local organizers that are volunteer with us and help us in this organization. Now I will introduce you the representations, representatives of some institutions and associations that supported us in the organizing the event. And first of all, I was supposed to introduce you the president of Tuscany region, but maybe he will arrive a little bit late, so we will wait for him if he will be able to come. So I will skip this slide. but it's a pleasure for me to leave the floor to the to Professor Deborah Berti. She's the Vice Rector of the University of Florence that hosted us in the Morgaving Teaching Center. Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay.
Can I take the t-shirt?
Yes.
No, I'm kidding. No, I was just kidding. So hello and welcome everyone. Thank you, Bianca, for the kind introduction. Thank you, Luca. Good morning to all attendees. As Bianca introduced, my name is Deborah Berti. I'm the Vice Rector of the University and its Deputy for Research. So our Rector could not make it today and I'm representing her. And it is my honor to officially welcome you in Florence to attend this conference, Phosphor-G. So when I learned that I had to be here today, I had a look at the website of the conference and of the previous annual conferences, and I realized that this is nothing like a regular meeting. It is a forum for a collaborative development of free and open source technologies and data, of course. So it's like a multifaceted meeting where institutions, researchers, training bodies, IT professionals also, and scholars of different disciplines talk together, identify a common ground for enhancing knowledge. So building on the success of this previous meeting, the contribution presented at the satellite meetings will concern the use of geospatial information in a very multidisciplinary, let's say, environment and background. So when I say multidisciplinary, I really mean it. I was really amazed by that because the range of application is huge, from biodiversity to humanitarian, let's say, work, development purposes, peacekeeping, digital twins, space exploration. So I was really amazed. I'm a physical chemist, I must confess, so I really have no background in the conference topics. But as a scientist and as a citizen, first of all, I'm aware that we all live in a fragile environment, and the very coexistence of humankind with our planet is challenged every day by climate changes, energetic crisis, wars, and related issues, which affect not only the natural world, nature, but also, let's say, the man-made world. For instance, we are in Florence, so I'm thinking about cultural heritage, to quote a very Florence-related examples. Therefore, what will you will discuss in this forum related with the observation of our environment, with most importantly, open source resources, touches one of the most challenging and urgent topics of our time. So I'm not bold if I say that. So I'm sure that you are aware of that and you will make a good use of this opportunity. So based on the number of participants and also on the, let's say, geographical diversity of the attendees, this conference had an excellent success, and I really congratulate the organizers and the chairs who have accepted the challenge of such an essential topic. So the possibility to follow the work online also helped, but I'm really overjoyed to see this wide attendance here. The number of countries represented is impressive, and when I walked in the yard, I could see really people from all around the world. I could see from their face, languages, and it's really something. After 2.5 years to see such a thing. And we have very important sponsors, but also the attendance of all the European Space Agency, United Nations, Italian ministries, regions, etc. So the interest of the academic field is outstanding. I'm sure that the proceeding will really be a landmark in these issues. I must say, I have other speakers after me. We will make a better job in that, but the backdrop of the beautiful and historic city of Florence will add to the pleasure of this meeting, and I hope it will provide lasting memories beyond science, technology, and innovation. So thanks a lot for being present, and special thanks to those who made Force4G possible, Luca, Bianca, but also I must say the group of the University of Florence who take care, the Geomatic group, the Department of Civil and Environmental Engineering, led by Grazia Tucci. And without further ado, I think that I will leave the floor to the next speakers. Thank you for being present, and please feel very, very welcome. Thank you.
Yeah, thank you very much, and me too, I want to really thanks Professoressa Tucci that support us at the University of Florence to organize all this event. Thank you, thank you very much. I will go on introducing you, Elisabetta Meucci. She is a councillor of the municipality of Florence. She is also referent for the teaching university and high teaching in the municipality. And she will bring us the greetings from this splendid, beautiful, welcoming city, the city of Florence. Thank you.
Buongiorno a tutti, benvenuti nella città di Firenze. E veramente sono onorata e lieta di portare il saluto personale di Dario Nardella e anche a nome ovviamente della Giunta Comunale di Firenze e di tutta l'amministrazione. Dario Nardella mi ha proprio chiesto personalmente di rivolgervi questo saluto, si trova fuori città, ma anche lui è consapevole dell'importanza di questo congresso che si sta svolgendo nella nostra città. E effettivamente è un saluto che va a una edizione del congresso annuale, il congresso internazionale di FOS4G, un'edizione che a noi sembra di grande rilievo e non soltanto per il notevole afflusso di partecipanti che confermano, diciamo, che si tratta del principale luogo di incontro, di opportunità e di condivisione sui temi e gli argomenti finalizzati al sostegno e alla promozione dello sviluppo collaborativo delle tecnologie geografiche libere e dei dati geospaziali aperti. Ma non solo questo, perché mi sembra che la vera specialità di questa edizione stia nella individuazione della sede, stia nel fatto che questo importantissimo congresso annuale internazionale per la prima volta si svolge, appunto nel 2022, si svolge per la prima volta in Italia e affronta in queste giornate quelle tematiche di grande attualità che da molto tempo vengono portate avanti dalla comunità italiana FOS4G e da tempo molto attiva, come si sa, nel contribuire a diffondere il software libero geografico. E consentitemi di dirlo come rappresentante dell'amministrazione comunale, mi sembra che ancora più significativo sia stato quello di scegliere, il fatto di scegliere Firenze come sede di questa prima volta italiana. E perché Firenze, al di là dell'attrattività, no, turistica che induce i partecipanti anche a affrontare lunghi viaggi, però Firenze rappresenta un luogo intrinsecamente adatto ad ospitare un evento di tale natura. Perché scegliendo Firenze voi avete scelto la città in cui da molti secoli la cultura non è soltanto una cultura letteraria e artistica, ma è anche e insieme cultura scientifica. E proprio nelle vostre materie, voglio ricordare che da secoli è presente qui un'istituzione quale l'Istituto Geografico Militare, e saluto veramente con grande affetto, direi proprio come amministrazione, i rappresentanti dell'Istituto Geografico Militare che hanno contribuito nei secoli all'evoluzione delle conoscenze in queste materie. E quindi con questa scelta voi avete reso omaggio a Firenze perché avete contribuito a renderla protagonista dell'attualità, ma anche a proiettarla nel futuro. E quindi per questo fatto io, a nome della città di Firenze, ringrazio tutti coloro che si sono impegnati per raggiungere questo magnifico risultato, in particolare il comitato organizzatore rappresentato dal dottor De Lucchi, insieme a tutti gli altri attori della città, a cominciare dall'Università degli Studi di Firenze, insieme al Firenze Convention Bureau, Firenze Fiera, AIM Group International, ed infine io vorrei ringraziare tutti voi partecipanti, voi che siete presenti qui nella nostra città, e a voi tutti auguro un calorosissimo benvenuto e buon lavoro per i vostri lavori. Grazie.
Grazie mille, thank you very much.
Okay. The next one that I have the pleasure to introduce is the Deputy General Giuseppe Poccia. He represented the Ministry of the Italian Ministry of the Defense and mainly the Military Geographical Institute that is based in Florence. IGM was established 150 years ago and has a Military Topographical Institute to produce Italian national cartography, which is currently shared via National Geoportal or the IGM website. So thank you very much for the work that you have done and that you will do. And here, the floor for you to the greetings.
Thank you for your kind introduction. Good morning, everybody. My name is Giuseppe Poccia. I am a Brigadier General, Deputy Commander of the Italian Military Geographic Institute. And I am very glad to be here today and bring you my warmest greetings on behalf of IGM. First of all, I would like to thank the chairman of the conference, Mr. Luca De Lucchi, for his invitation to be part of such important event. I am therefore grateful to all those who have worked to make this event possible, as well as the speakers and all the participants. The 16th edition of the conference highlights the importance of having reliable map services, both for public administrations and citizens. My daily work allows me to say that there is still a strong need to raise awareness about the importance of geographic information as the pillar for all activities related to land security, prevention, planning, and management. We are proud of the recent tradition of the Italian studies about the field of geographical information science and of the continuous technical progress that contributed to make the volunteer representation of Italian lands, which also cannot be ignored by the official representation of our country, in charge of the official bodies. In Italy, there are 5 official bodies. Official cartographic bodies in charge of producing official geospatial information. The Italian Military Geographic Institute, the Navy Hydrographic Institute, the Directorate of Cadastral, Cartographic and Land Registration Services, the Geological Survey of Italy, and the Air Force Geotopographic Information Center. Instead, at a local level, the similar task is assigned to the administrative regions and autonomous provinces. All of these bodies are committed to produce the necessary geospatial information for the broader needs of the country. Italian Geographic Military Institute operates as a national mapping agency and for the last 150 years, already in the aftermath of political unification into a single sovereign state, it has enabled our country to have geometric cartography and geodetic networks of the territory, achieving the scientific and operational goals that have marked the course of history. To this day, the Institute is still working, serving our country with the same dedication and commitment to produce accurate and reliable geographic data. Among the many activities carried out by the Italian Military Geographic Institute, let me briefly mention at least the main institution tasks performed. the inspection and maintenance of the national boundaries of Italy, the achievement, management and maintenance of national geodetic networks, the achievement, management and maintenance of the national synthesis database at medium scale, the collection and the treatment of the official Italian toponymy, the digitization of historical cartography books and magazines belonging to the Attilio Mori Library, which are part of the Historical Museum of the Italian Cartography since 2017. These are just some of the tasks performed by the Italian Minute Geographic Institute, always ready to serve our country. I am completely sure that in order to change the relationship between us and our planet, the contribution of voluntary geographical information is absolutely essential. They are important for an ever more detailed knowledge of territory and for the growth of active citizenship, but it is necessary to be fully aware of the importance of having up-to-date, reliable and certified geographical information, without ever neglecting the security aspects, as the recent world events in the heart of Europe remind us all. Finally, I would like to express my best wishes for the success of this important event. Thank you for your kind attention.
Thank you very much. And we will move from the national to the international level. And it's a pleasure for me to introduce Elena Alonova. She is president of ISPRS, that is the International Society of Photogrammetry and Remote Sensing, and that help us in the organization of this, support the organization of this conference, and offered us to publish the academic paper in the International Archive of Photogrammetry, Remote Sensing, and Spatial Information Science. Thank you, Lena.
Thank you very much for introducing me. It's a pleasure to be here, and it's a pleasure to give greetings from ISPRS as a society which is closely connected with 4G. If I go back to the history, ISPRS, International Society for Photogrammetry and Remote Sensing, was founded already in 1910. So it's more than 110 years ago. It was founded in Vienna, in Austria, so it's not far away from Florence. And that time, Florence and Vienna created the same country, Austrian-Hungarian monarchy. So the connection started already in that time. And G from Phosphor G was something which we can find in photogrammetry. Photogrammetry is based on image processing. That time, these were aerophotographs. Aerophotographs allow the people to create maps. This is something which brings us back to the history thousands of years ago, when our predecessors wanted to know what is on the Earth, how to find the way, and so on. So photogrammetry allowed us to create the maps in a more accurate way. And photogrammetry was a science which was studied already in the 19th century. So the history showed us how the people came from earlier years up to now. And it was in 1980 when the International Society for Photogrammetry, this was the original name, was changed into the International Society for Photogrammetry and Remote Sensing. So it was remote sensing which got the name in 50s of the 20th century, was involved also in that society. And we analyzed not only aerial photographs, but also satellite imagery. And this is something which was a big break in the society and in the human life, because we started to work with satellite imagery and with digital data. And we go further on, and then we can find the initiatives which appeared in academic sphere. And this is the initiative related to GIS. And first steps were done by academicians. The following steps were done by commercial sphere. But commercial sphere is always connected with financial requirements of users. So then we can find a differential of two lines, two directions, commercial one, and later on, the open one. And this is the step which you are followers of our predecessors. And I would like to thank all of you who are working for, not only for 4G, but for open source, which allows many people who are without financial resources or with limited financial resources to use free of charge your advances. And it's something which started in the group you are now creating, much larger than it was before, but it was something which convinced also politicians that not only open source, but open data and open science become very important part of the human life and of the human society. So now you can find initiatives which started to support open science, not only in your group, not only in ISPRS members, but also under the umbrella of UNESCO. So we are stepping further on to something which creates cooperation in the whole world and which allows also countries and scientists from areas which were not aware about GIS, about geospatial, about information technologies, to work on it and enlarge their knowledge and implement such tools also for their science, which wasn't before, for medicine, for lawyers, and so on. So thank you very much for your endless work. I congratulate you to so many young faces which follow the philosophy to have open mind, open source, philosophy, so data, and software, and mind, human mind. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Lena. Thank you very much. Okay, I will conclude this session, and then I will leave the floor to Luca again. Introducing you, Vicky Vergara Castillo. She is the vice president of OSGEO. I think everybody, all of you know what is OSGEO, but just two words. OSGEO is the Open Source Geospatial Foundation. And OSGEO is the organizer of the conference with our local help. So thank you very much to OSGEO, thank you very much to Vicky to be here with us.
Buongiorno. Namaste. Konnichiwa. Annyeonghaseyo. Buenos días. Bonjour. Guten Morgen. Guten Morgen. I'm for sure, I'm certain that I'm missing many languages. This reunion, it has developers, users from all over the world. It's been a very big effort from the local organizing team of Italy to have us all together and share our experiences developing and using the free open source software and the open data that it's done by the OpenStreetMap group. I hope you enjoy all these experiences that we're sharing in all the presentations that are going to happen, and enjoy Phosphor G 2022 in Firenze. Thank you.
So, now some practical information. We are now in the Palazzo dei Congressi, where the general talks will be, and also the keynotes. Palafari is the building where you register and in which of the academic track will take place. Coffee break will be held both here around the auditorium and in the first floor of the Palafari. Please, if you are interested in following the talks in the academic session and those in the Limonaia room, go for the coffee break at the Palafari. There will be less queue there. It will also be possible to follow the keynote talks from the module 3 room, so you can stay there and take the coffee directly there. The lunch will be served at the Fortezza d'Abasso in the Caverniglia Pavilion. Getting there takes about 10 minutes by walk, so be on time when you come back for your presentation. A lighting welcome cocktail will be offered tonight to all the registered participants, and the icebreaker will be in the garden of Palazzo dei Congressi after the last talk of today. The social dinner will take place tomorrow from 20 to 33, so 8 p.m. and 11 p.m. in the Caverniglia Pavilion of the Fortezza d'Abasso, where the lunch will be. Then live music will entertain you for the rest of the evening until 12:30. After that, you will be kicked out. Okay? We are going to look for all the bigger people around and we'll push you out. Due to the hybrid nature of the conference, we have to ask you to make your question on this for the speaker on Venueless. You should already be familiar with the platform. It's the same that we used last year. And in the slide, you can see how to do that. Please use it, because the people online can vote your question, and so we know what all the people registered want to ask to the presenter. These are useful links depending on the role that you have. If you haven't checked them out yet, and there are a lot of you that didn't do that, do so during the first coffee break. Please provide your slide the day before or half day before to the slide center. It is just back here. If you don't provide the slide then, you will not be able to make your presentation. Remember that no laptop and keyboard will be available during your speech, only the mouse and the screen. I would like to take this opportunity to thank all the session chairs who volunteered with their time. There was some complaint on Twitter about our choose to use the slide center to use PowerPoint and PDF, or to suggest to use PDF and PowerPoint. But it's quite difficult to have a hybrid in conference that should be stream everywhere and also in online, also on site. So I'm sorry about that, but we have no other solution, or at least the other solution were more difficult than this. There are several options to you for follow the program. Choose whichever is suit to you best. Venules, I think, and the app are probably the best ones. So, and there should be an update every day if something changes. So you will get also some notification and stuff like that. For the social, because we are really social, I'm not so much, but you are. The official hashtag is Phosphor G 2022. Use it, and you can see that around there are some screen and the Twitter going there, and everyone can see. Maybe I will sit in front of some and I will check what you are going to write. Wi-Fi network usually is important stuff. It should be really good. The IT department here, they say that they can host 1,000 people here, with all the people connected with the Wi-Fi, and it should work well. And password and network name is Phosphor G2022. It's quite simple, all uppercase. Group photo. The group photo will be taken tomorrow at 1 p.m. Please be on time if you want to be there and also to be in the picture. This is a really important event. The code sprint will be held at the university, where the workshop were. If you want to attend, please register as soon as possible to allow for a better organization. There will be also an aperitif in the afternoon, so maybe this can convince you to come. Right now, in Italy, there are no specific COVID restriction related to conference and in general around everywhere. Only in the public transport is required to use the mask. In addition, a red silicone bracelet will be available to senior who is available to for hugs and a shake. You can take it at the registration desk at the Palaffari. Let people wearing the bracelet choose how to greet you. So, I would like to really to thank for Firenze Convention Bureau. Sorry. Because 4 years ago, take in mind if you want to organize a Phosphor G in the next years. So 4 years ago, they asked and pushed us to apply for the bid. And I'm grateful for all the work they did, from the proposal to the final organization of these amazing days. I'm done. Probably will not meet me around in this day. I will escape. And I really hope that you will enjoy the conference. We did our best for you. So enjoy the conference, enjoy Phosphor G 2022, and see you around.